بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Today we have inshallah the summary of Surah Toor. Surah Toor is Surah number 52 and it has 49 verses and it is the 76th Surah in sequence of revelation. So let us begin with Surah Toor.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والطور وكتاب مسطور في رق منشور والبيت المعمور والسقف المرفوع والبحر المسجور إن عذاب ربك لواقع ما له من دافع
صدق الله العظيم سورة الطور سورة number 52 begins with an oath, a qasam that Allah Azza wa Jal takes on a few things. والطور on Mount Tur. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, I swear by Mount Tur. وكتاب مستور, and the written book, the scripted book. And first of all, what is Tur? Tur is, according to some, it is the actual Mount Tur in which Musa alayhi salam received nubuwat, prophethood, and spoke to Allah Azza wa Jal for the first time. According to others, Tur is any mountain that has trees or vegetation on it. But what Tur, the specific mount, makes more sense here, as we will learn. Wa kitabim mastur, and the written script, Allah takes an oath. I swear by the written text, by the written book. What is that? According to some, it's our book of deeds. According to some, it is the Quran. But in the context of Mount Tur, the most plausible explanation is that it is the Tawrat. Fi raqim manshur, and the spread scrolls, manshur nashar, the scrolls that have been spread. Again, scrolls that have been spread could possibly be referring to the Tawrat, because the Tawrat is written in scroll form even to this day. Wal baytil ma'mur, and Allah says, number four, I swear by bayti ma'mur, the house that is most often frequented, most often visited. Now this could be the bayti ma'mur in the heavens, because parallel to the Kaaba in the earth, there is a Kaaba in the heavens for the angels, and we find that through a sahih hadith both in Bukhari and Muslim. So Bayt Ma'mur could be referring to that Kaaba in the heavens, or it could be referring to Baytullah, the Kaaba on earth in Makkah. Wal Bayt Ma'mur wa Saqf Marfu', and Allah Azza wa Jal takes an oath in the canopy that's above our heads that has been raised, in other words the sky. Wal Bahr Masjur, and the ocean, the sea that is blazing with fire, that has been ignited, and it is, and the fire is in full blaze on this water, on the surface of this water. This is close to the end of time, close to the end of this world, and Quran speaks about that in the 30th juz. In the 30th juz, wa izal biharu fujirat. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ, when the ocean is ignited with flames. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Anyhow, Allah Azza wa Jal takes an oath on many things in the Quran. And the point of Allah Azza wa Jal taking oath is to show the significance of those things and to draw our attention to those things. And but what is the jawab qasam? What is the answer? Because a person takes an oath. I swear by Allah. I swear by Allah what? I swear by Allah I will not smoke again. So that is a jawab qasam. That is the answer. Muqsam alay. So Allah Azza wa Jal takes an oath. And after taking an oath on all of these things, then what? Inna adhaba rabbika lawaqi'. Allah says, indeed, the punishment of your Lord, lawaqi', is going to occur. Ma lahu min dafi', there is no one who can repel it. Before moving on, this surah is very similar to the previous surah, which we covered yesterday, Surah Al-Dhariyat. And you can see the similarity in many of the ayats. For example, over there it was innama tu'aduna lasadiq wa inna ad-din lawaqi'. Again, the same word lawaqi' is being used here. Over there it was after Allah took a qasam on four types of winds. What did Allah Azza wa Jalla say? Innama tu'aduna lasadiq. Indeed, what you have been promised is going to occur. Wa inna ad-din lawaqi'. And the day of recompense, the day of judgment, is surely going to occur. Here Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Inna adhaba rabbika lawaqi'. Indeed, the punishment of your Lord is surely going to occur. There's another other ayats are also similar to Surah Dhariyat. Another ayat that is similar is in Surah Dhariyat. It's akhidina ma atahum rabbuhum. The people of Jannah, they are taking whatever they are receiving from their Lord. Here it's faqihina bima atahum rabbuhum. There it was akhidina ma atahum rabbuhum. Here it's faqihina bima atahum rabbuhum. Enjoying the fruits that the Lord is going to bestow upon them. So you will see similar. That's why it is called a pair. That this surah, Surah At-Tur, is a pair with Surah Al-Dhariyat. Anyhow, moving on. Now we're going to jump to verse number 17, where Allah Azza wa Jal describes the people of Jannah. Innal muttaqina fi jannatin wa na'im. Indeed, the people, indeed the God conscious, they are in gardens and na'im, in bliss, in pleasure, in enjoyment. Fakihina bima atahum rabbuhum. Enjoying the fruits that their Lord will bestow upon them. Wa waqahum rabbuhum adhab al jahim. And their Lord would have saved them from the painful torment of Jahannam. Kulu washrabu. Eat and drink. Hani'an bima kuntum ta'malun. This is a hani'an, to your satisfaction. Bima kuntum ta'malun. Because of what you used to do. Because of what you used to do, the good deeds you used to do. In another surah, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "Kulu wa shrabu hani'am bima aslaftum fil ayyam al khaliyah." Eat and drink because you, to your satisfaction, because you stayed hungry in many of those previous days in the worldly life. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, for those who are fasting, Allah Azza wa Jalla will announce, eat and drink to your satisfaction because you spent many days and many weeks without eating and drinking in this worldly life. Moving on, وَزَوَّجْ مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَى سُرُورٍ مَصْفُوفَ. They will be reclining against rows of couches. وَزَوَّجْنَاهُمْ بِحُورٍ عِينَ. And we will wed them off, we will marry them off to companions who have large, magnificent eyes. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ. And those who believed. وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ. And their families followed them. بِإِيمَانٍ in faith. Their families followed them in faith. أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ. We will join them with their families. We will join the families with them. Those who did good and they are in Jannah. Let's say the parents are in Jannah, or the father is in Jannah, or the mother is in Jannah, or the husband is in Jannah, and the wife is in Jannah. The other family members are also in Jannah, but they are in a lower rank. They are in a lower rank. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, we will join these people of the lower rank in, and we will move them up into the higher rank so they can join their father, they can join their mother, they can join their parents, they can the wife can join her husband, the husband can join his wife, as long as they are all good doers. Now, if there is one family member who has done evil, if he has done evil and he is in Jahannam, may Allah protect us, then of course this person will not be taken out of Jahannam and moved up into Jannah. So, and all of that is mentioned in this ayah, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ. This is ayah number 21 for those who are at home and would like to read the translation. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believed. وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ, and their families followed them in faith. أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ, we will join their families with them. وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, and we will not decrease anything from their good deeds. The people, the family member who was in a higher rank, Quran is saying we will not decrease anything from his good works, because to bring him down to a lower rank of Jannah would be to decrease something from his good deeds. Allah is saying we will not decrease anything from his good deeds. وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Then كُلُّ مْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِيدٍ. But each person, yet each person is tied down to what he has done. Each person is bonded to what he has done. In other words, if a person has done evil, he is going to have to pay the consequences of the evil that he has done. وَأَمْدَدَنَاهُمْ, moving on, وَأَمْدَدَنَاهُمْ بِفَاكِهَةٍ وَلَحْمٍ مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ. We will bestow upon them, give them fruits, وَلَحْمٍ, and meat, مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ, which they desire. يَتَنَازَعُونَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا. They will exchange with each other, pass to each other, كَأْسًا, cups of wine. لَا لَغْوٌ فِيهَا وَلَا تَأْثِيمٌ. They will not be any idle talk, and they will not be any sin. In other words, the wine of this world, what happens, the immediate effect is the person gets drunk, and when the person gets drunk, he starts spewing garbage from his mouth. He says things which he later regrets after he becomes sober, that I should not have said those things. When people inform him, this is what you said when you were drunk, this is what you did when you were drunk, he regrets and he is embarrassed by what he said or what he did. Quran says they will have this drink, la laghun fiha wa la ta'thim. It will not cause any sin or a shameful talk. وَيَتُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ غِلْمَانٌ لَهُمْ. And they will have servants that will come to them, كَأَنَّهُمْ لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونَ. And these servants will be as beautiful as hidden pearls. وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. And moving on from this is ayah 25. وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. They will ask each other, people of Jannah will inquire from each other. قَالُوا إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ. They would say, in the worldly life, we were living with our families in a state of fear, that that we would be fearful of displeasing our Lord. فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah has showered His grace upon us. وَوَقَانَا عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ. And has saved us from the scorching punishment. إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلُ نَدْعُوهُ. We used to call upon Allah before. إِنَّهُ, in the worldly life, we would call upon Allah. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْبَرُّ الرَّحِيمُ. Indeed, He is kind, He is merciful, He is compassionate. Now, the people of Jannah, the people of Paradise, conversing with each other, you will find that quite frequently in the Quran. In another place, Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in Surah Saffat, فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. They will start to inquire from each other, the people of Jannah, and they will say, إِنِّي كَانَ لِي قَرِينٌ. We used to have a friend. And يَقُولُ, he would say, أَإِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ. Do you believe in these fairy tales? Do you believe in this nonsense that there is going to be a Jannah and a Jahannam? يَقُولُ أَإِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ. أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَإِذَا مَنْ أَإِنَّا لَمَدِينُونَ. When we become dust, when we become bones, and even our bones have decomposed, then are we going to be brought back together? And then a voice will call out, in other words, Allah Azza wa Jal, or an angel will say, هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُتَّلِعُونَ. Would you like to see him? And then they will, فَاتَّلَعَ فَرَآهُ فِي سَوَاءِ الْجَحِيمِ. And then they will look down and they will see that person who they were friends with in this worldly life. They will see him in the middle of Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So the people of Jannah will be conversing with each other, having conversations. People of Jahannam will also be having conversations. Their conversations will be of a different nature altogether. Their conversations will be blaming each other. blaming each other. It's you. I followed you. And look how you have misled us. Oh Allah, give this person double the punishment. Allah Azza wa Jal will say, لِكُلِّن ضِعْفٌ. Both of you will have double the punishment. So blaming each other. And what will their conversation be? It will be screams and screeches and sounds of pain and agony. May Allah protect us. Anyhow, moving on, Quran speaks now, verse from verse 30 all the way pretty much till the end of the surah, closer to verse 43. So 30 to 43, Allah Azza wa Jal is asking some questions in rhetorical form. And these questions begin with and you will find the emphasis here. Am yaquluna sha'ir? Do they say that he is a poet? Am ta'muruhum ahlamuhum bihada? Am hum qawmun taghun? Is their faculty of intelligence? Is their mind putting them up to this? Am hum qawmun taghun? Or are they just simply an arrogant bunch of people? And then Quran will say, Am yakuluna taqawwalahu? Or do they say that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making this up? Balla yu'minun, or would they rather not just believe? Am khuliku min ghairi shay'in? Am humul khalikun? Did they themselves get created? Or are they the creators? In other words, there's only one of two options. Either you are the creation or that you are the creator. So Allah Azza wa Jal is asking, are they the creation or are they the creator? Am khalaqus samawati wal ardh? Or did they create the heavens and the earth? Am indahum khazainu rabbik? Do they have the treasures? Or do they have the treasures of the heavens and the earth? Am lahum sullamun? Or do they have a ladder? Yastami'una fi, that they can climb up and listen? Am lahul banatu walahul banun? Do they have daughters and he, Allah, has sons? Am tas'aluhum ajran? Or has Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked you for any money? Asked you for any wages or compensation? Am indahumul ghaib? Or do they have news of the unseen? Am yuriduna kaydan? Or do they want to scheme and plot against Islam and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Am ilahun ghairullah? Or do they have a deity other than Allah? Subhanallahi amma yushrikun. Allah is above and beyond all they associate with him. I wish you could only enjoy this in Arabic, how Allah Azza wa Jal, one after the other, like a drum beating on their head, is asking them to think, is it this? What are all the possible scenarios? What is it? Is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking you for money? How come you don't think? Are you the creation or are you the creator? If you don't think you are the creation, then you most definitely must be the creator. And if you are the creator, then how come you haven't created the heavens and the earth? So Allah Azza wa Jal is asking them to think. And this is one of the beauties of Islam. Islam tells you to think. Quran is asking you to think. Ponder. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Why do they not ponder over the Quran? Many of the religions in the world, to reach Allah, you have to close your eyes. Islam is one religion where if you want to reach Allah, you have to open your eyes. Quran says, look at the universe. Look around you. أَفَلَا يَنْذُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبِلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ. Do you not see how the camel was created? Do you not see how the sky was lifted? Do you not see how the mountains have been pegged into the ground? Do you not see how the earth has been shaped and flattened? Allah Azza wa Jalla is asking us to see, right? Yes, there is a place for meditation and you could close your eyes. That's a different story. But in general, Quran is asking us to see and to think and to ponder and to use the faculty of sight and the faculty of intelligence that Allah Azza wa Jal has given us to come to this conclusion that there is one Allah and there is one creator who has created this, and he is the one who has sent prophets for our guidance. If a person has reached the moon, and he has invented the Hubble telescope, which can take pictures of distant galaxies hundreds of millions of miles away. But he has not come to this conclusion that there is one Allah. Then he has misused his faculty of intelligence. His faculty of intelligence is first and foremost, it is to come to the conclusion, looking at the world around us, looking at science, looking at the universe, looking at the oceans, that Allah Azza wa Jal is the creator, and فَتَبَارَكَ أَحْسَنَ الْخَالِقِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal is the best of creators. And then the secondary use is to use it for the advancement of this world and the people of this world and the benefit of the people of this world. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to use our intelligence, this God-given faculty, for the right purpose. And with this, I conclude. Jazakumullahu khair for joining me today. And I hope to see you again soon, inshallah, for another episode of 20 Minutes with Allah. Assalamu alaikum. وحملته في فلكك المشحون يا من أحال النار حول خليله روحا وريحانا بقولك كوني يا من أجبت دعاء نوح فانتصر وحملته في فلكك المشحون.